For those of you who are taking thesis seminar, I wanted to share a page that I created in Notion called Stuff I'm Reading. What I'm doing here is as I am coming across different posts, I tend to go online pretty much every day and tweet out different articles that I think are interesting. Some of these articles might be of interest to you based on your studies. Now, I want to make a clear point. The examples that I'm sharing here are not to be used as references. Okay, these are not going to be citations that you're going to include in your theory or anywhere as citations throughout your paper. But what I want to share with you is a way that you can go about thinking and adapting and getting some ideas that complement some of the articles that you have been finding. Let me give you an example. The idea of reciprocal teaching. Now, this article, again, it's very basic, very short, but that's why I think it's useful, because we can get some very quick ideas about how we can maybe implement certain practices, right? Things that you might be observing. This might give you some ideas about a type of activity or material or technology that you could incorporate or bring into your own research. So in this particular article, it's called How to Implement Reciprocal Teaching in Your Classroom. This might be something that you either work with your participant teachers with, you know, maybe you work with them in trying to adapt a classroom environment through reciprocal teaching. Maybe this will provide the information that will be useful for you based on your research questions. In this particular case, it mentions self-regulation. And I know some of you are building a theory around self-regulation, right? So this is an example of how self-regulation lines up with a very practical teaching technique called reciprocal teaching. And so this is what you're going to be thinking about. Whether you choose this particular teaching technique or not, the idea is that we're linking these into our theory. All right, so this is one example. I have another one here, something on working memory. This might be relevant as well if you're thinking about vocabulary, for example. Some of you are working with vocabulary, so some mention of working memory versus short-term memory. Again, these articles are very short. They're not to be used as references, but you can get ideas and some key terms, perhaps, that will help you look for other research articles regarding the same topic. Okay, so for example, here we've got reasoning and comprehension. We have, of course, the terms working memory, short-term memory. These are all potential key search terms that might help you find some of those last articles maybe that you're still trying to find. Here's an article on stress. Some of you are focusing on teacher stress, maybe even burnout. Again, these articles, these are websites, and we're not going to include any websites in our references, but that doesn't mean we can't use websites and Wikipedia to get some ideas, and maybe this will lead to other, perhaps, authors, depending on what they discuss in these blog posts, essentially. These are blog posts that are related to education that does serve a purpose in trying to get some ideas about different directions that we want to take our own research. So I'm going to continue adding to this page. If this is useful, of course, check it out and use it. And here's another one on game-based learning. Some of you are thinking about gamification. And again, a very short and precise advantages, disadvantages, and implementation. So think of this not only in terms of key terms that will be brought into your theory, but also maybe something that you could bring into your own research when you collect data. Maybe this might be a teaching technique or approach or material or technology that might be able to occur when you're choosing your own participants, when you're thinking about, if necessary, an intervention where you're working with students, with students or with teachers, trying to help them create the environment, the classroom environment, that will be useful for you to answer your research questions. Remember, our goal here is to pose 1 to 3 key main research questions that will drive both our theory and our own research. Our theory is set out to answer those research questions. And then when we start to collect our data, starting in Unit 2 on March 8th, we'll begin collecting data to try to answer those same research questions ourselves in our own research. Okay, so this page is in Notion. It's called Stuff I'm Reading, and I will continue adding different content, some links to some of the topics that I know that you're working on. If you're not sure how to interpret some of these articles or what to do, if you're not sure how to use some of these articles to find something that's related to your research topic, then that's something we can talk about in our tutoring sessions. It's something that you can send or ask about by questioning, maybe posting a question in your Word document, and we can certainly address those issues.